After finding herself on the wrong end of a photographer's lens, she was forced to rethink her shape when pictures like this appeared in the papers and inspired her to shed nearly 3 stone. Here to reveal all about that transformation, please welcome Claire Nazir.
Shrunk.
You have.
Oh, God, unbelievable.
Yes. I saw you on the London programme the other night, and literally they said, now over to Claire for the weather, and I honestly didn't even think that it was you. Yeah. It's just so incredible a transformation.
It's been sort of 4 months of just working hard. It's been challenging. I've eaten a lot, actually, but the right food, and I've just been working out and just sort of preparing myself.
How have you done it, though? Because I know you.
I know.
You're normal. You don't do things like this.
And you know
this.
Me from lots of long lunches at GMTV, which is what we did at GMTV. But
you've got a baby. How do you find the time to work out as much as you
have? Well, the type of exercise I've been doing over the last sort of 6 months has been sort of based on boxing. And really what sort of sold it to me is that boxers can burn up to 8,000 calories a day through their routine, their sort of workout routine. So that's what I've been doing. And so I've been doing something, I know this sounds a bit technical, but I like a technical phrase, high intensity interval training. So it's equivalent of doing maybe an hour and a half of jogging, but it's 10 to 15 minutes.
Mass? An hour and a half of jogging?
Yeah, but I don't do that. No, I've been doing... No, Colleen, it's all right. That's the best thing about it. 20 minutes is equivalent of doing so much more of other things. So you get your heart rate right up into your neck and then you just feel absolutely shattered, and then you do something called active recovery, which is a few sort of weights and stuff, and then do it again and again. So you can really squeeze in a lot of exercise into a short period of time and then get on with your life.
Like a circuit training.
You know, we've shown the picture, picture.
You must be sick of it by
a few times. And you've actually put it on the cover of your DVD.
Where's the bumpy bits gone? Where's the cellulite bits gone? They've just gone.
Do you know, I can't believe it. I really... And the worst thing about that first photo was people have said to me, was it a fat suit? No, I actually look like that. And now they're saying, well, you've been airbrushed.
Actually,
and I haven't.
Do you know what my first question to you? Why on earth would you wear that out in a public place?
Do you know?
That's hideous.
It is hideous. In fact, someone else said that to me.
Look at that. That's hideous. Not only is it hideous, look at the colour of it. Are
well,
you mad?
I'm an 80s chick, you know. Lime green was good in the 80s.
I won't wear that in the bedroom.
Good. In the bedroom.
But to be fair, I said to Denise, that picture, I mean, any woman really that's not ultra toned and is a gym bunny has got cellulite, and in sunlight and mid skip, we ain't all far behind,
you know.
Really not.
No, so it was a hideous photo. It was probably one of the worst days of last year for me when that came out. I remember walking into the newsroom at GMTV about 4 a.m. You know what a happy place it is.
Yeah.
It is. Everyone's just jolly because you have to be at that time of the morning. And no one would speak to me. And I thought, I don't understand. Have I done something wrong? Am I going to be sacked? And I went downstairs, and apparently the editor said, don't tell Claire about those photos until she's on the weather. Because, it would put me off at the very least.
Yeah.
But someone downstairs wasn't briefed. And she said, oh, my God, Claire, what were you thinking? And it was just the most horrific moment.
Had you been aware that you were going to have to address your weight before that photo, or was it
seeing
that?
Well, no, I was addressing my weight, Denise.
That's
I was exercising, and I was really thinking, no, I'm really going to get control over this. Because that weight, I was...
Yeah.
As heavy as that before I'd had my baby, before I was even pregnant.
Yeah.
So I'd battled with weight since I got
married.
But
you're little as well. That doesn't help.
Yeah,
you're quite small.
You mentioned as well that, you know, obviously the photo, although it spurred you on to, you know, make a life-changing decision in terms of your fitness, what other changes do you think you would like to see for 2011? Because, I mean, you look fab, you know, you're doing the weather still on ITV. Mm. Is there anything else you'd like to see?
I'm really, really happy about where I am right now. Mm. And so I haven't really got many changes sort of coming into this new year. I feel fantastic. And last year was one of the toughest years for me. Mm. It was life-changing. I had a baby. I went back to work a bit too early, to be honest.
Yeah.
And then, you know, GMTV finished and it broke my heart. Because I loved that show and it was part of my family.
Yeah.
But so lots of things changed for me. So this year, I've started this year feeling
brilliant.
Amazing.
Yeah,
yeah.
You know, at last, for
once. What does your hubby think? Has he still got enough to, you know, get hold of?
The other day...
the other day, he was in bed, because we go to bed a bit early, because he does an early morning breakfast show, so we're tucked up in bed by about 8:30, 9 o'clock, and I saw him take his glasses and put them on and have a good old double take at me, and I thought,
ooh,
yeah.
Did he?
And that's not because I was wearing any lime green or anything like that.
Actually, you talked about GMTV. Can we show you the picture that you're most famous of, or the clip that you're most famous of at GMTV? it's not quite ready yet, but no. Basically, you know, we were sent out in all weathers, and it was almost like, I mean, it wasn't competitive between us, but I think it was between the producers in the back. Where can we send them next? That's the most hideous. And you won. Take a look.
I think you'll see some sunshine, mostly dry, and just the odd.
Oh my God! Oh no!
Bless you.
Is she all right? Well, we've clearly lost the sound, but she's smiling. She's waving her arms. All vital functions are still intact.
I was scared. I was really scared. In fact, the whole crew got knocked back down by that 10-foot wave, apart from the camera, which just stayed where it was, amazingly. And it was a really stupid thing to do. I shouldn't have been on the seawall, but you know what it's
but
like.
But we did it all the time.
We did it all the time. Stone, you wouldn't have had a chance, would you?
It blew me away to Belgium.
Well, do you know, Claire, you're barely recognisable. There it is. Claire Nazir's boot camp. I'm going to be nabbing this.
It's fabulous.
It's
fabulous.
Good
it's a brilliant DVD, and it's 20-minute sections, so you don't have to do the whole thing.
Okay.
It's changed my life. It really has.
Well, I know what happened to you. It's so bizarre.
Yeah, but you look beautiful now. You were beautiful then, though, still.
And I was going to ask you to go for a wee glass of wine after the show, but will it be herbal tea?
No!
Oh, go on then.
Let's push the boat out. Let's have two.
Oh, lovely to see you, Claire.
To see
and give my love to Sienna and Chris as well.
Yeah.
It's Claire Nazir, everyone.